Hey, everybody. It's Charms. What happened last time? No, it was the Sight Unseen one. With the... Yeah, I remember. What was her name? Abby? God damn it. Abby was breaking in. She was stealing Prue's things. And also, Invisible Guy was walking through doors. And also, Cole was just waltzing through pretending to be concerned about them. We got two of them in a crystal trap. We obliterated one of them, although the source, the triad, they obliterated the invisible guy before he could say too much. But yeah, I assume that Prue will be suspicious of Cole going forward. Maybe a few comments here and there. And I assume Phoebe will fall ever closer to him. And I assume that he will fall a little bit for Phoebe. Come on. Come on, guy. You saw it in the apple, remember? See? Leo and Piper are fine. So, that's where we are. This one's called... Oh yeah, Primrose Empath. I don't know what it means, but it seems... It kind of seems nice, you know? She practicing? What's up, Prue? Can't move that fork? What's she doing? Careful, don't stick Phoebe.
Oh my god, you lost your powers?
Can't lose what you never had.
But... Oh, she's drunk. I get it.
Marco!
Hello.
Hello!
She's just trying to see if she can do it as an astral projected person.
Trying to use telekinesis in astral mode. I studied up on Balthazar. The triad couldn't have sent us a worse demon.
Oh, how bad
no
is...
one with worse skin.
Yeah, that's what he looks like.
I would hate to find myself alone with this guy.
Yeah.
I have a date with Cole.
Oh!
I can't believe you haven't taken care of that
toothache.
Dentist appointment in an hour.
Oh, maybe that tooth fairy can help her. What you think of him, Phoebe? Pretty cool, eh? You're not the dentist. Oh, he can astral project too. Well, teleport. It's not the same. Good advice. Okay, follow the arrow. Oh, I wouldn't go that way. Okay. That guy's following the arrow. Where is Cole leading her?
You need to ignore the signs and get yourself into a dentist.
Which way are we going, dude? Final stop?
Guy won't come out of his loft up there, and we're supposed to start demolition today.
Let's help this guy.
Poor guy says he hadn't stepped outside in 4 years.
Maybe he's doing reaction videos. You don't need to go anywhere to make those.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Why is Cole leading her here? Seems like someone genuinely does need help.
The door. Go away.
Yeah, but they're...
I just want to talk.
They're going to bulldoze your building. She could astral project in there, take a peek around before...
Don't come any closer. Pain. You're letting it in.
What pain?
Everyone's pain.
Oh, he can... He's the empath.
I feel all of it.
I won't hurt you.
We just need to put him in a Faraday cage.
All your pain. I can't stand it. Why didn't you just go when I asked?
She's giving him his toothache. That's not good. Maybe Cole just really hates this guy and he wants to torture him. Nah, I don't know what's going on.
I just can't believe you introduced me as a friend.
Okay, Harry Grainer.
I'd introduced you as my fiancé. She would have asked how we met, when we're getting married, where the hell my ring is. Questions.
Yeah. Where's her ring, Leo? Hey, do you go to the dentist? No, Cole.
Cole pulled up behind me.
Good timing.
We followed her.
Look, it's my lunch date.
Sorry I'm late. You look amazing.
It's all part of my master plan.
Phoebe, I wanted to talk to you about this incredibly tragic guy who's scared to leave his own home, which might be okay if it weren't about to be torn down.
Let me, make a call, see what I can do.
Kitchen.
This is interesting. Also, here's the question. If your building is getting demolished and you live in the building, does that guy own that apartment? Like, what's the situation? Do they give you a load of money to go somewhere else? Like, they can't just destroy the building and, well, now you live in the rubble. That it's just city ordinance. It's just sort of the city. We were told we had to. Do you like rocks? I assume they buy out the building. And unless he's renting. If he's renting, then I guess the person who owns the building could just give them, like, hey, look, gotta be out of here in 2 months because they're knocking the building. That's probably the way it is. Yeah, I just answered my own question. But that wasn't why I bought it. Curious about Cole here, because he's center there. And now he's going to see if he can help with this situation. Like, I can imagine if Cole senses that Prue is hostile towards him, he could manufacture a situation where he would come out the good guy and win a bit of her trust. But it hasn't reached that stage where he would feel the need to do that yet. So maybe something else is going on. Beep, beep, beep. Oh, what's the shadow doing?
Whoa.
Hey.
Where are you going?
Get back here.
He agreed no more triad reports, not until my plan succeeds. Phoebe.
Hey.
Oh, jeez.
I just need some aspirin.
Would you even notice? You wouldn't notice, would you? Hey, you stay away from her, Shadow. Maybe it's a separate entity? You know what I mean?
Based on everything you said, Prue, it sounds like your shut-ins.
Gotta pause it just to talk about the Shadow. Because we've never talked about the Shadow before. It seems like the Shadow is... It's attached to him. It does his reports to the Triad. But they're not the same person. You know, it's not like he's... It's not like when Prue astral projects, you know? I feel like this Shadow is... could turn on him at any point, you know? That's the sort of relationship I feel about. He's like, hey, I thought we agreed. Don't report to the Triad until... After this attempt, it's all going to plan. Just hang on a second.
They're mortals who can actually feel what other people feel.
I don't think this guy would look at it as a gift.
Well, it could be he's rejecting his gift, fighting the emotions he feels instead of embracing them.
What I don't understand is who sent the signs that you followed.
It could be them, could be...
Cole.
Yeah, it could be Cole. That's right, Piper, you got it.
The housing authority who really will get your shut in. Have him page me.
Thanks.
Ready for lunch?
Mm.
Lunch would be great. Would you mind if we join you? That'd be great. Two couples on the town.
Double date.
In the real world.
Why not?
Yeah, this guy. The freaking mayor.
No. I have to get out. Stand there tearing it down. I have to get there.
Hold on now. I must protect the innocent.
Well, okay. Now we got an extra... a new character.
Hey.
You think he's connected to the guy in the psych ward?
Can't go outside.
We'll clear the street. Maybe Piper can freeze everybody.
You feel fear and panic because something's coming for you.
Oh.
Something you're afraid you can't stop.
A demon, dude. He's pretty gross looking.
This is not a gift. This is a curse. I am cursed. I can't go outside that door. Not now. Not ever.
I'm coming in.
Oh, this guy's coming in though.
Hey.
Do you see me do this? Do you see me do this?
How'd you do that?
I'm here to help you, and that's what I'm gonna do.
She's an angel, dude.
Release his gift. Let his pain be cast adrift.
Oh, did he pass it on to Prue?
Thank you. You don't know what you just did for me.
You don't know what you just took from him, I think. Prue's strong, though. We've seen that.
Let's get you out of this dump. What's the matter with you?
Oh, is he evil? Well, that's what happens when you take somebody's empathy away from them, and also they have demonic powers. one to think about, isn't it? Imagine a demon, like, who, like that, you know, has no empathy, goes around killing people. That they're cursed with the curse of feeling everybody's feelings and pain. Then you can't kill them because hurting them is hurting yourself. So you almost go crazy with the power. You shut yourself away. Tell me, what does the guy in the psych ward know about all of this? How is he connected to it all? Also, did Prue just absorb that guy's... What did that spell do? Did she take it for herself? Or did she just magic it away? And that would be a good power to have, even if only temporarily. She could feel... Maybe feel what Cole is thinking. Feel what Cole is thinking? That's not a phrase of words. Either is that. But yeah, the guy in the mental hospital? Was he involved? He knows about it, right? So we're going to have to meet him at some point. Yeah, what's the plan, Cole? What is the plan? Well, firstly, we got to get lunch. We can't do anything on an empty stomach. So let's get into that.
So...
This isn't awkward.
How about those Niners?
Yeah.
You don't follow football?
He isn't human.
We're gonna be right back.
Are these two gonna talk?
She's been through a lot of loss.
I sense that.
Whatever your intentions are, I want you to be straight with her, okay? And I don't want to see her get hurt.
Heaven forbid.
Heaven forbids.
I have to take this. Forgive me.
It's the triad. I'll be back later.
Balthazar.
Got your pay.
Dude.
It went down just like you said.
Wow.
I could feel the empathic cancer pass out of me and right into her.
That's how you got it, isn't it?
From the other guy, maybe? In the psych ward?
I give her a day until the weight of human emotion crushes her.
I'll be out of town. I don't need to see the other two suffer the loss of their sister.
Compassion. From you, Balthazar. I think maybe you've been undercover a little too long.
Oh, I'll strangle you.
But I couldn't get out of work. Is there any way that Dr. Timmons can fit me in?
Look at the lovebirds behind her.
I really need to...
Are you okay, Miss Hallowell?
Did you just touch my bum?
You haven't said anything... since we left the restaurant.
Yeah. And now we know why. Now we know why. He doesn't want to see Phoebe get hurt because Prue's going to go crazy and explode from the inside out. He doesn't want to see Phoebe, you know, react to that. He has to go to Chicago with their dad. So we know that Cole is feeling a little... You know, he's getting a little... He's pulling away because he's getting a bit close. It's the old classic. But of course, Phoebe, from Phoebe's perspective, he's probably just not that into her. He's pulling away. And she's like, you know, just be real with me. What are we doing? He's got to make up an excuse until the end of the episode and the plan doesn't work, but... You know? Or maybe it will work. We don't know. Hey, where does Primrose come into all this? Did I miss that reference?
A lot on my mind, I guess.
You don't want to see me anymore, do you?
It's not you, it's me. And my plans.
It's complicated.
I think that I deserve to know.
I promise you'll understand soon.
Oh, does she feel anything from him? Guilt? Sadness? Rage?
Are you okay? I haven't felt anything... like that since Andy was alive.
Oh.
Spinning into infinity.
Prue, what the hell are you talking about?
True love, I think.
Falling in love.
Who's falling in love?
Cole.
You're so off track.
Oh. You're falling in love, too.
We got a problem.
crew cast a spell to remove Vince's pain.
It went straight into her.
Maybe I was meant to have this gift.
But Prue, you're not an empath. You're just a witch.
Will you guys please stop being so negative?
We didn't say anything.
Yeah, but I can feel all of your...
Oh, was that you, Prue? Did you do that?
I think I did it.
Oh, shit.
Go to him, all right? Tell him what's in your heart. I think you'll find him receptive. He wants you.
Prue's a great sister. Look at this. And as for these two...
We have couple issues?
Resentment, denial, be nice. Oh.
Their issues this episode are nothing. Nothing. Prue, it's okay. You can come... No. Yeah, don't come down. Her range is pretty large.
Phoebe, what are you doing here?
I came to tell you something.
Well... This has progressed from lunch. he's trying to resist. He can't resist anymore.
You have no idea what you're getting yourself into.
Neither do you.
Spirals, Phoebe. The triad, Phoebe. They're gonna eviscerate him unless he gets you.
Good morning.
He's genuinely, he's happy.
You're hiding anything from me?
Yeah, big
you
one.
You don't have to hide it.
It's a big one though, Phoebe.
If you're in some kind of trouble.
I can handle it.
I can help you.
No, you can't.
Interestingly, she's not getting any visions from him.
Am I going to see you again?
One way or another.
Oh, this got really complicated for them, didn't it? And now that they've been together, the betrayal will be off the charts.
Oh,
it's getting worse. It's getting worse. Freaking guys across the street. Talking about their trash cans. That's not good. But yeah, obviously, Leo was talking about the gift, the empath gift. And that, you know, goes to, you know, people are born and, like, they're either... psychotherapists or, you know, psychiatrists or social workers or priests in this case, you know, someone who can use that gift and really make a difference in people's life. And obviously at some point this priest had a run in with that demon guy and they made contact and went into him, and then once that happened, the priest felt like he lost something. He couldn't help anybody anymore. He, you know, the thing that his whole life was based on, the foundation of it just fell out from under him. And he's like, well, what happened? And it's not that he's crazy. He's just forlorn, you know. He can still help. He can still, you know. But I know what it, you know. It makes sense, story-wise. This is a good episode. I like this episode. I like what Prue felt from Cole. And it all makes sense, you know? The timing of it, when he was leaving, he knew he was... You know, he's so conflicted, that character. We still don't know exactly what his deal is, what his story is, what his deal with the triad is, what he wants to get back, you know, what he's doing all this for. And now he's deep in with Phoebe, and I know in the book, and they're building up him up to be such a bad guy, but I don't know, he doesn't seem that bad. I mean, he's obliterating demons and he's very intimidating and everybody's like, oh shit, this guy. But he hesitates. He has a bit of a, he's not like this guy, that guy. It's not like he's lacking empathy. Maybe that's it. Maybe he feels too deeply. Maybe you know, he wants this thing, whatever it is, so passionately, so I don't know. Again, I'm trying to read into a situation that we have no information about, and that there's no point. I just kind of wanted to talk about it. That's all. You know? Sometimes you just want to talk about things.
What are you doing in the basement?
The emotions, they're everywhere. I can't get away. I'm picking up things from other people's houses. I just wanted to go away.
Maybe we can pass it around. Give it to Leo, maybe. You know, because he's a sparkle and he can... Or give it back to the priest.
All night?
Mm-hmm.
Was he...
Mm-hmm.
Can we talk about this later?
Cole said that Vince never called. I'm starting to smell a demon.
Do we get any clues from this place? Clues. Let's go.
We're definitely right about the demon theory.
What was the last murder you saw?
A man at a mental hospital.
Hey, Santa's here. Maybe he can help.
Hi. Excuse me. Are you an empath?
He was.
You people don't have to humor me, you know.
We're witches, and we're looking for the empath who cursed a demon.
I was working as a priest, helping people when it came after me. Vinceris is a demonic assassin. Unstoppable.
Unstoppable.
You didn't cast a spell.
You did.
Yep.
I gave up everything to prevent that beast from killing again. If it's free, you can't stop it.
Oh, the TV. I'm surprised they let Prue leave the psych ward. I know it's not funny, but the way she was shaking, like completely shaking, like she was crazy. If any of the doctors or nurses were there, they'd probably just assume she was a patient and not let her just walk out. Oh, but Piper had frozen a bunch of people. But Piper should just keep freezing everybody around her. I don't know. Can't we cast a spell and put it back into the priest temporarily and then he can curse the demon? Again? That's what I thought was going to happen. I thought we were just going to pass it to somebody. Just say the spell again.
You can't reverse the spell. Vinceris is immune to witch's magic.
Prue's spell worked.
That's because the demon allowed it to work to its own advantage.
Now, what do we do?
Look, you use this power to stop this demon. Now my sister has your power. Deal with it and then help us.
You're carrying a cross you were never meant to bear. I'm sorry.
Your sorrow, I can't take it.
The feelings are ripping you apart because you're fighting them. A demon can't handle human emotions. You can.
Oh, here he is.
Anybody home? Where's Father Thomas?
Quimby!
Did that work? Nice! Again! Yeah! He knows kung fu.
Take my hand.
I can't control my power.
Yeah, you can. I know I'm posing a really emotional scene here, but after this fork thing, it's gonna be no problem. Oh, forks everywhere. I gotta go flying. I wouldn't want to be a waiter after this episode. Remember, Doug?
Don't be afraid.
Just tell me where the empath is, and I won't kill you.
If you want the empath, you're gonna have to go through me.
What the hell? What the shoot? Did you see that? Oh, yeah. Nice. Oh, Agent Smith. Oh. It's total Matrix. Oh, she just went into him. It is the Matrix.
The voices are gone.
Did she lose the power? Is it?
So you're not an empath anymore. I'm sorry. I was hoping that we could return your gift.
But you did. It appears I have the ability to understand people are feeling even without a magic assist.
That's what I was talking about. Oh, back to the club.
How did you vanquish Venceris? Demons cannot handle human emotion.
And so you astral projected into his body.
I forced him to feel and he couldn't take it.
But if demons can't handle human emotion, what's Cole steal? Because he's got a whole boatload of emotion spiraling out of him. Prue felt it. You know? It was just that guy. Everybody, all those demons have emotion. Even the Grimlocks. They got pure hate. Yeah. I like this episode.
What's up with you and your coal dependency? Where do you guys stand?
I have no idea. I think I'm gonna go find out right now.
Yeah, what are you doing here?
Yeah.
Seize the day.
Hi.
Hi. I half expected not to find you here.
Well, an associate of mine didn't do as he was told, so I've still got work to do here.
Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
Both.
What you got yourself into, Cole? He's done for. He's in too deep now. So, where to start with that one? With episode 6? Whew. Hey, where did Primrose come into it? Did you know? Like, the church wasn't called Primrose, right? The demon wasn't called Primrose? Was the building called Primrose? The insane asylum wasn't called Primrose? Maybe it's just a nice name. A story all about empathy. And it turns out that priest, he had the power inside him all along. He didn't need any supernatural gifts to be able to tell, to be able to connect with people. See the way he connected with Prue? You know? He knew exactly what to tell her for her to be able to deal with this torrent of emotion inside her, to focus it and to use it with her power and her... She'd been taking classes with Phoebe, you know? So she was able to funnel it into her martial arts skills too. That fight was great. That... I know she was super souped up, you know? She had a bit of an edge, but there were some good moves there. And she was taking him on. She was one hand behind her back, you know? She was... You know, she was very... That this episode is very homage-y. I'll say that. Also, we got Harry from that other show. He was great in that other show. I'm not going to spoil anything about that other show. But I kind of did in the reaction. But, Just who he was. But yeah, good to see him here. He's a good actor. And he played the part really well. Actually, so did the non-empath, the unempathic demon guy. He played his part pretty well. He was great as the shut-in, you know, dealing with the emotion. And then instantly when he lost that, you could just see nothing behind the eyes, nothing in the heart. He was just... You know, turning people into Balthazar cosplay, you know? Turning their faces all red. We had a dinner date. We had a lunch date. And we had the slightest issues between Leo and Piper, which Prue was picking up on. Everything Prue was picking up on, the funny parts, were great. You know, before she was overwhelmed. She played that very well as well, the being completely overwhelmed by emotion. But the highlights were definitely the funny parts. Her reading everybody in the room. The couple behind her at the dentist's place. When she touched that guy's ass and his girlfriend was like, "Ah, oh, You cheating dog, you. With her? Oh, that guy. He did nothing wrong, but maybe he did. You know, maybe he deserved it. Who knows? Who knows? And yeah, Cole was directing the whole thing. He was just slight little signs, little arrows, roadworks, you know? Just to, because he knew that Prue would take that gift and then she would, like, explode. Like, she was going to cause the massive earthquake, fault line earthquake, once she couldn't handle it anymore. It was just getting more and more and more and more, and combined with her power of telekinesis, it was just going to go, which would have destroyed her. And without her, there is no Charmed Ones. There's no three. You need three. So that would have, the Triad would have been like, oh, speaking of three, they would have been rejoicing. They would have thrown Balthazar a party, given him party hats and balloons, and whatever it was they have a deal about. And yeah, happily ever after. But see, Cole knew that Phoebe and Piper would be, he doesn't care about Piper, but he knew Phoebe would be completely destroyed, like, even if she wasn't physically destroyed by Prue, she would be emotionally devastated. And he was like, I can't be around for that. I can't. And a part of his brain is like, why can't I be, well, like, what's going on with me? Why can't I be around for that? What? He's like, you know what? I'm getting a bit too close. I need to go. I'm just going to go. I'm just going to pack my bags and go to a different town. So he leaves the house. Prue walks in. She's like, holy shit, that guy is falling in love with you. Whether he knew it or not. And Phoebe goes to him and he's like, sort of resisting a little bit, and then he's like, oh crap, I can't. It's just like, there was only one destination for that. And then for a moment, for like 30 seconds, when they wake up the next morning and they're giggling together, for those 30 seconds he's not thinking about the master plan. He's not thinking about all the shit around that's circling around them. He's just thinking him and her in that place, and she's thinking the same thing. It's a little bubble of kind of perfect, contented existence that obviously never lasts. You know, once the seconds tick by, the real world seeps in slowly, and life goes on, plans start coming again, and he's lying to her, but he's also telling her the truth, you know, that she doesn't know what she's getting herself into, and, you know, it's a good thing and a bad thing. She doesn't know. And, oh, and Prue wasn't suspicious. She had a lot of things to deal with. I was suspecting when she got that empathic power that she would pick something sinister up from him, but luckily for him, she passed him at that one point where he's feeling the most for Phoebe. So, yeah. Yeah, I enjoyed it. I enjoyed pretty much all of the episode. You know, sometimes the B story, sometimes the story with whatever case of the week they're working with can be a bit kind of boring, like this super rich family is having some sort of spat and we have to help one of the people in the family, and I'm like, I don't care about those people. But in this episode it all felt part of the same story. It was all just one story. It was all connected. It was all, everything worked with itself. And yeah, I don't know what you felt about it, but I felt pretty good about it. Yeah. I wonder if she will be able to get that power to do stuff when she's astrally projected. You know, she just needs to see, I feel, this is me making up shit that I don't know anything about. She has to feel that the power isn't coming from her astral projected body. Her astrally projected body is just an extension. It's just eyes. It's just a visual. The power is coming from her original body. And she has to feel the space between her and her astral body and direct it from her original position to be able to... That's what I'd say to her if I was given advice on how to move that fork. Or she could just do crazy Matrix stuff. I wonder. Also, I don't know if it's kind of a cheat, but in this episode, she did kind of look at herself when she was astrally projected. They did sort of, they were both sort of awake. You know, usually Prue goes down into a trance state before, but in this episode it looked like they were kind of double teaming, like there were two of them fully conscious. Maybe it was just for this episode, just for the what they had to do in this episode. Anyway, we know that the power of three Prues, if she ever, what if the astral projected one tries to project? If we get three Prues, they're unstoppable. The power of three Prues, remember? Anyway, thank you for joining me for this one. Come back for episode 7. Episode 7 is called Power Outage. We know what that means in this show. They just didn't pay their electric bill. That's all that could mean. See you next time.